Hello and welcome to Fintech Focus TV. I'm Toby Babb and delighted to be joined today by Ranzie Anthony. Ranzie, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Listen, yeah. Thanks so much for coming over today. Tell us a little bit about what you do at Athlon and your background.
Great. So I'm a co-founder and a chief creative officer at Athlon. We're an experience design and technology company. So effectively what that means is we work in three key areas. One of those areas is user experience. Mm-hmm. The other is brand. The other is technology.
Yeah.
We're a team of 70, so we're based in London, New York, and Bulgaria. And really, what we're doing is we're working with a lot of fintech companies to really help accelerate innovation.
And probably one of the key areas as well at the moment around.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, how they're using their platforms, their technologies, their apps, their websites to provide products and services for customers. Mm. We're really helping them in that area.
Yeah. And are you taking stuff from outside the industry and bringing it in, or?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think one of the big things in the industry at the moment is change. Mm. And customer expectation is being based on people's experiences with Amazon, with Facebook, mm. with Google. Yeah. And then you've got disruptors like cryptocurrencies, you've mm. got disruptors like open banking. So all of that is causing a lot of change in terms of customer expectation and behavior.
Yeah.
And we're really taking those principles and working with our clients to help them reimagine their products and services.
Amazing. And what sort of, you mentioned clients, what sort of organizations are you working with?
Yeah. So we're working with banks. So a mixture of specialist and global. So Deutsche Bank and Investec are some of the larger banks that we work with, yeah. Alongside Nomura. Yeah. We're working with debit networks. So yeah. we do a lot of work with Interac out of Canada. Yeah. Through to some of the new market entrants. So BitGo is a cryptocurrency wallet, and we're working with those guys. So really we're working with across the sector, yeah. And really helping, you know, shape the way that these new products and services will come to life.
And it's interesting that you've got such a spread of clients across it. Do you think the bigger companies there have responded specifically to the changes in the fintech marketplace and the disruptors?
I think they've got challenges, yeah. and some of those challenges include legacy IT systems. You know, following the global financial crisis, the focus was much more shifted towards regulation mm. and risk management rather than innovation.
Yeah.
So with that, they've been slow to move.
Yeah.
But I think that now they're starting to really realize that they've got to innovate. And whether that's innovating through partnerships,
yeah.
Or through acquisitions of new technology, or actually looking at how they can really accelerate their own product development.
Yeah.
But yes, they've still got a way to go to catch up.
And do you see major challenges other than that sort of stuff, you know, coming through for companies in fintech?
Yeah, I think the biggest challenge we see, and certainly that I see, is that gap in customer expectation.
Mm.
So increasingly, people are becoming frustrated with their banking experience.
Mm.
And when you have something like open banking, which effectively is going to democratize, if you like, the way in which banks use your data, non-banks are going to be able to enter that space and potentially provide better customer experiences than traditional banks can.
Yeah.
And once that happens, banks potentially could start to lose out on that customer relationship.
Yeah.
So it's very, very important that they focus on, you know, their products and services, the user experience around that,
yeah.
and how they can accelerate innovation yeah. to maintain that relationship with their customers.
How specifically can they do that? What sort of things do you...
So we, for example, run a 30-day accelerator workshop,
yeah.
whereby we go in and we audit the current state of the nation, if you like, or the current state of a product or service.
Yeah.
And we really look at some of the key wins that some of these organizations can put in place to start to change things more quickly.
Mm.
That can range from, sometimes it's a cultural thing, you know, kind of years and years of kind of moving quite slowly.
Yeah.
You know, it's that ability to bring fresh thinking, kind of design-based methodology into some of the existing problems that they
and you're
have.
You're seeing people being open to that as well at the moment.
Yeah, very much so. Yeah. I mean, and also...
Just say it's very traditional and conservative sometimes, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. And yeah. I think it's that new design thinking and that creative thinking to sometimes establish problems.
Yeah.
You know, one of the other areas that we've found quite useful is that our development teams can talk to their technology teams and bridge that gap. So whereas you may have a marketing side of the business which really wants to innovate,
yeah.
and you've got the technology side of the business which is very much focused on risk and mitigating that risk and established processes,
yeah.
that can be an area of tension. So being able to speak to both parts and having individuals who can speak and understand the concerns of both of those areas.
Yeah.
You know, we're often brought on as the honest broker, if you like, to kind of, you know, yeah, find a path, you know, to navigate those challenges.
Brilliant. And we've spoken about some of the trends already, just now, talking about the sort of, I guess, advance of user experience in the marketplace. We've talked about, you know, mentioned crypto and blockchain and such like. What do you think the other big trends we're going to be seeing are?
So I think artificial intelligence and machine-based learning is going to be interesting, and chatbots along with that. So if you think about the context of customer service and banks introducing, or financial organizations introducing chatbots into that, I think there's an element of, well, how can you trust the data? What does the brand experience look and feel like around that? So machine-based learning and artificial intelligence has presents a huge opportunity for FS. But again, looking at it through the lens of customer experience and what that looks like is some of the challenges that they're going to need to address.
That's the danger, right? I mean, we talk so much about user experience, and to dehumanize it, where potentially that customer experience should be at its peak, is interesting.
Yeah, absolutely. And it needs to come at the right point on the customer journey.
Yeah.
So at the point where you're browsing for wide-based information, or you just need an answer to a very quick question, that's okay. But once you want to actually get into some quite specific information about your own personal financial situation, a chatbot is going to be less relevant. So understanding that customer journey, understanding where it's relevant and how you can use these technologies along that journey.
And that's through iterative research, I guess.
That's through an aspect of research, an aspect of auditing the journey. I mean, a lot of the work that we do is mapping pain points. So understanding, you know, where are your, who are your customers, and where is the experience really delightful, but also where is it a bit of a problem? And let's focus on that, and let's focus on introducing technology or tools or systems or thinking which changes that.
So it's exciting times of change.
Absolutely. I think that during a time of change and a time of disruption, you know, it's a fantastic opportunity to innovate. And I think that the organisations which are really embracing that are the ones which are going to win and succeed.
Hopefully I'll do that working with you.
Fantastic. Brilliant.
Listen, lovely to speak to you. Guys, thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next episode of Fintech Focus TV. And Ranzie, thanks very much.
Great speaking to you. Thank you. Brilliant.
Cheers.
Thanks.